Hey guys, I'm Brian with Fix My Blinds. Today we're going to look at a Springs Window Fashion vertical blind. This one's the G98. It's under brands Graber or Bally. Yours might say UltraView or Magnum on it. But this is a high quality vertical blind, but some of the pieces that do break pretty often are going to be the carrier clips, and we'll show you how to replace those today. All right, so today I'm going to show you how to replace a standard carrier clip. So it's any of the ones that follow this master carrier clip. And I'll also show you how to replace this master carrier clip. It's going to be quite the different process to do each one of them. But we'll start with the standard clip, just because that's most common to what you'll have to replace. So the tools you'll need to replace the stem and gear on your G98 head rail are just a stem and a gear in these vertical blind stem pliers. Before we go ahead and replace it, let's look at how it goes together. That way we know how to take it apart. So here is a standard clip that's inserted into the gear. There are small tabs on the base of this clip that you will have to compress in order to remove from the gear. So for that, we're gonna use these pliers to compress it, and it's pretty hard to do with just without it being in the blind, but you would compress that and it would pull out of this gear. So let's go ahead and do it on the blind. So here's a broken standard clip. One thing you want to make sure is that these clips are perpendicular to the head rail. If they're parallel, you won't be able to compress the tabs. So that's very important. So let's go ahead and take our pliers. We're going to stick it on the base of this clip. Goes pretty far down there. We're going to squeeze fairly hard, pull up on it, and it comes right out. This repair can be done while your blind is still in the window. We're just doing it on the bench for this instructional video. If you do need to replace these gears, if it's not rotating properly, then it's easy to just to push out the side. Again, if this was hanging in the window, you just have to be careful that this doesn't fall down a heat register or something like that. So there you go. There's the broken clip. We'll go ahead and put a new gear and a new clip in it. So there's two parts to this, two sides to this gear. This flat side actually goes towards the opening of this carrier. So we'll go ahead and slide that in. Alright, let's go ahead and slide that in. And then there's a few things to note about putting these stems in as well. So for this clip, there is a small nub on one side. You want to make sure that's facing the same direction as the clips already installed in the blind. There is also a small nub at the base of this opening. You want to make sure that is on the inside of this D shape right here. So I'm going to go ahead and put it in even slightly wrong. You can see how it's not perfectly lined up with the other clips. And that's okay. If that does happen, these are self-aligning blinds. So you just take them, twist them one way, twist them back the other way, and they'll click back into place. So now this one is lined up with the rest of them. So that's it for a standard carrier stem and gear. Let's go ahead and move on to the master carrier stem and gear. So the tools you'll need to replace the master carrier stem and gear, or just the tilt control itself, is a new tilt control, a replacement push nut, needle nose pliers, some regular pliers, Phillips screwdriver, and some gloves. So you can see that this carrier clip is also broken. For this one, we can't just replace the clip because the pieces it's connected to, you can't access it with those pliers. So we're gonna have to replace this entire wand control. So the first thing I'll do with this is I'm gonna take some needle nose pliers and remove this wand. So you'll take the needle nose pliers, insert it into this metal clip, and just spread it apart. Comes off just like that. We'll set this aside for later. All right, the next thing is we need to remove the screws on the end caps. So I'll take a Phillips screwdriver and just take out these small set screws. And we'll do that for both sides. Set that aside. All right, for this next part, we do have to remove these end caps. These head rails are sharp, so I like to wear gloves when I take these off because it's a pretty small space you have to push with a lot of force. So I usually just use one glove. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna be pushing this end cap down. You should hear it pop just like that. It'll come right off. So you can see those corners are pretty sharp, so that's what you need to be careful for. So let's go ahead and do the other side. Push that down. All right. All right, so now that we have the end caps off, we're able to move the train down. That way we can have access to the wand control. But there is one problem. We still have a push nut on the end over here that we're gonna have to remove. So push it all the way down. So we're gonna have to take off this push nut. So for that, I'll use the needle nose pliers. The thing with these is the new, if you buy a new replacement from Fix My Blinds, they come with a new push nut because they do tend to break very easily. So usually when I take it off, more often than not, it just breaks. But that's all right. So now that we have that off, we can work on removing this from the rest of the train. So there is a small piece of metal that is sticking up that we just need to compress with some pliers. This one comes right off. So we have our new wand control. If you notice, the holes of these have a small, like, half moon in them that you will need to line up with the cutout in the tilt rod. So just take note of that when you're putting it in. There we go. All right, now we need to put this back through under that plastic piece. All right, so you can take your needle nose pliers and grab that tab and pull it back up. So now that it won't press back through. Now you want to make sure that that doesn't get bent too much, stays straight, so it doesn't get caught in the rail during operation. All right, now we got to put the idle end back on. So we'll go ahead and put this on. The part with this almost V shape goes down. And we need to attach the push nut where the old one was. So just make note of where the old one was. There's a little notch in this one, so it's pretty easy to see. I'm gonna start it by hand, and then I'll use the pliers to work it on. Oh. Yeah, if you have a push nut tool, it makes it a whole lot easier, but you can do it this way as well. Just work it on slowly because it can break. All right, that looks like where it was before. So let's go ahead and slide this back in. If they come out, you just need to make sure that these spacer straps aren't getting caught, because you could break the plastic pretty easily. There we go. All right, now we can slide this end cap all the way back to the end, the opposite end, down to the end. We just need to reattach the end caps. So again, I'll go ahead and put on my glove. This time we'll flip it over so that idle end push through. So if you keep your finger in there to keep pushing out a little bit, that should help. There we go. There's one end. Let's do the other end. Flip it over. Keep your finger in there pushing the idle end out. Push down. That's installed. All right, so we just successfully installed the wand control in order to replace the stem. That can be applied if you need to replace the whole thing or just the stem. Once we get the wand back on, we'll use the self-aligning feature to get that in line with the other ones. So let's go ahead and put this wand back on. So we have this metal clip. We'll put it through the opening of the wand control. Then I like to use some bigger pliers to grab on first before we start putting the wand on. So get that in position. And then we can slide the wand in. Squeeze it closed. So now we need to fix the alignment of this one. So now that those are all in line, we can do a quick test just to make sure everything is holding in place before we put the set screws back in. It does look like everything's rotating fine, as well as traversing fine within the head rail. So let's go ahead and put these set screws back in and we'll be all done. Side. So that's it for today. We successfully replaced the stem and gear and the wand control on a G98 head rail. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. We'll see you next time.